Welcome to Avatar Technology Digest. Again, get ready for exciting news on technology, medical cybernetics, and artificial intelligence. And here are the top stories of the last week. Can aging be slowed by using gene therapy to make permanent changes to a person's DNA? Elizabeth Parrish, the 44-year-old CEO of an American biotechnology startup, says she underwent a gene therapy to reverse aging at an undisclosed location in Colombia last month, a first step in what she says is a plan to develop treatments for ravages of old age. She's the patient zero. Now, judge for yourself. Gene therapy preparations, which use a virus to shuttle DNA into human cells, could prove risky, but the technology has advanced so far in the last decade that it is within reach of a small company. Parrish says she had received two forms of gene therapy produced under contract with a commercial laboratory, which she did not identify outside the United States. In one treatment, she says, she received injections into her muscle containing the gene follistatin, which in animal experiments is shown to increase muscle mass by blocking myostatin itself, an inhibitor of muscle growth. She says she also received an intravenous dose of viruses containing genetic material to produce telomerase, a protein that extends telomeres, a component of chromosomes known as the aging clock. Telomerase is a frequent target of anti-aging research because the molecule is present in cells that can continue to divide indefinitely, like stem cells and tumors. The idea for extending lifespan using telomerase, for instance, is based on work of Spanish scientists who in 2012 showed that telomerase gene therapy could extend the lifespan of mice by as much as 20%. The group of Stanford engineers led by Benjamin T might have made a breakthrough that could change the lives of people with missing limbs. Researchers have developed an artificial substitute for skin that is capable of sensing when it's been touched and sending that data to the nervous system. The artificial skin is made of a clear plastic with a fingerprint-sized sensor embedded into it. The sensor is made of flexible organic materials, and the skin takes in information based on the amount of force applied to the circuit before translating it into digital signals. The researchers' main goal was to ensure that the sensors were able to mimic that same range of pressure that humans feel, thus creating a more lifelike feel with the sensors. To recreate these sensations, the researchers used carbon nanotubes, incredibly strong and small tubular cylinders. They fashioned these nanotubes into pyramid-like structures so that the more they were compressed, the more electricity they conducted. These electrical impulses were then sent to the brains of mice almost like Morse code, replicating in a way the process by which impulses on our skin are captured and information is transferred. For now, the researchers are aiming to overhaul the sensor altogether, creating smaller individual printed ones called pixels that can sense pressure a lot more accurately. Once that overhaul is complete, the researchers' next step will be to perform a trial on live animals. Military researchers are putting the final touches on a study of a skin substitute grown from a patient's own cells to treat complex burns and soft tissue injuries. The new research study underway at the U.S. Army Institute of Surgical Research in San Antonio holds promise for treating burn patients, including those with severe life-threatening wounds. The treatment, called Engineered Skin Substitute, or ESS, combines tissue cultivated from a patient's skin along with collagen-producing cells to replace the two top components of skin, the epidermis and dermis. Using an individual's own cells or skin to replace damaged tissue have been around for years. But the technology for rapidly growing replacement skin to use in large-scale burned replacement has lacked. Moreover, many current products replaced either one layer of skin or the other, but not the top two layers together. ESS already has been designated an orphan drug by the FDA to be used for investigative purposes to treat pediatric patients burnt over more than 95% of their bodies. It could help rare cases of civilian and military adult patients nationwide whose injuries include burns over more than 50% of their bodies. It takes skill to fall with grace. New research by Georgia Tech wants to protect expensive, wobbly robots of the future by programming them to fall safely and gracefully. In order to test this, first they need to shove over a bunch of robots. There are plenty of robots designed to avoid falling, like Alphabet's surreal animal-like Big Dog series of machines. But bipedal robots or bipedalish robots designed to operate in spaces made for humans don't have the luxury of a weird, well-balanced body. As a result, they tend to fall over a bunch. To compensate falling, scientists at Georgia Tech created a planning algorithm that lets robots break various kinds of falls, including using arms to protect the head and tumbling sideways to minimize the damage. The paper Multiple Contact Planning for Minimizing Damage of Humanoid Falls, presented at the International Conference on Intelligent Robots and Systems, details a system that lets robots survive a range of impacts. Aerospace Boeing has invented the lightest metal ever, called microlattice, and it's lighter than styrofoam. It's sort of like a feather. It floats down and its terminal velocity depends on the density. The product is 99% air and it will be used as a primary component in aerospace engineering. It will be used to make space rockets. By utilizing microlattice, Boeing could find ways to cut down on the weight of its jets and save substantially on fuel costs. It's an important invention because although it's lighter than foam, as it's made of metal, it is very strong. The metal-based microlattice structures are significantly less dense than the rarest aerogels and other ultralight foams, while exhibiting high strength and an unprecedentedly high ability to absorb energy and recover shape after compression. The structure is comparable to the hollow honeycomb structure of bone and is composed of a network of thin hollow struts. The struts are around 100 micrometers in diameter and have walls just 100 nanometers thick. Microlattice was first announced in 2011, but only now the research team released the footage. As you can see, it can sit on top of a dandelion without crushing the seeds, and if dropped from a height, floats down to earth like a feather. And that is all for Avatar Technology Digest. Thank you for watching us. You're welcome to subscribe, follow us on social media, and join the global conversation. Take care and see you soon.